Hey, this is 77, and today I'm going to show you how you can get the very first Need for Speed game, 1994's The Need for Speed, running on a modern Windows 10 PC. If you're watching this and you don't have a copy of the game on PC, unfortunately the game is not available on any digital distribution sites like Steam or Origin. Therefore, you will need to find an original physical copy of the game. In this tutorial, I'll be installing a version of the game called the Need for Speed Special Edition, or the Need for Speed SE as it's usually called. This is a more enhanced version of the game, therefore I recommend you track down a copy of this instead of the original. However, if you only own a copy of the original version, don't worry, this tutorial should also work for you. To make installation nice and easy, I suggest downloading a program called Launchbox, linked in the description. Launchbox is a game launcher and front-end for DOSBox, which will guide you through the process of installing MS-DOS games like the Need for Speed on a modern PC. Download and install Launchbox. It's pretty simple, so I won't guide you on that. Once you have it installed, click on the hamburger icon next to the Launchbox title, mouse over the Tools option and select Edit Default DOSBox Configuration. Click on the Audio tab and select the Gravis Ultrasound tab and tick Enable Gravis Ultrasound. Click OK and click on the hamburger icon again. Mouse over Tools and select Install DOS Game. An installation wizard will pop up asking you to type in the name of the game you're installing. In my case, I typed in Need for Speed SE, but you can enter whatever you feel like. Since the game isn't installed, we're going to pick No. Here we can tell the program whether we have a physical disk or have the game's files already on our computer through an ISO or whatever. I have a physical disk, so I'm going to select on a physical CD. I'll then confirm the drive that my disk is in. Next, we have to point the program to the file on the disk that installs the game, so we click Browse and it should open the disk. If you have the Special Edition like me, then you have to select Install D.exe as that's the installer for the DOS version of the game. If you have the standard DOS edition of the game, I'm assuming this file will just be called install.exe. Next, we have to tell the program where we want to install the game to. You can leave this as default if you wish, but I'll be pointing it to the folder that will house all the Need for Speed games I'll be covering for this series. On the next page, it'll ask us if you want the game to recognize that the CD is inserted when playing. Select yes for this. It will then ask if I want to copy the contents of the CD itself to the folder I'm installing the game to. This will allow me to play the game without having to find my CD every time I want to play, so if you're lazy like me, definitely select yes for this. The program will now copy the contents of the CD to the folder. This will take around 2 minutes, depending on the speed of your drive. Next, the program will tell us that it will begin the actual installation process for the game, and for this, it will run the game's install program through DOSBox. Give it a little time and the install screen should arrive. Select Install. You will arrive at this audio menu. Select Auto Detect, and then Test. If you can hear music, the sound is working. Then just select Done. You then arrive at this video test menu. Select
Before you click Done, just want to let you know that if you suffer from seizures that come as a result of flashing images, just want to let you know before you click Done, look away from the screen because there is a chance that the video test may be completely bugged and just show flashing colors instead of an actual proper video test. So just for your safety, before you click Done, look away from the screen. Alright, cool. Let's continue.
Done, and it'll actually run a video test. Don't panic if it looks like it's completely broken. This is normal. You'll then arrive at this install menu. Just select Done and hit Yes to proceed with the installation. Give it some time and it'll finish. Once it finishes, you'll arrive back at where you started. Select Quit, and it'll say the installation was successful. The graphics will bug out and you'll arrive at a prompt where you just need to hit any key. Launchbox will then ask you if it worked, and in our case, it did, so yes. The program will ask you to point to the game's .exe file in order for it to launch, which should be nfs.exe. It should find it by itself, but if it doesn't, select Browse and find it yourself.
And there you go, the installation is complete. Once you hit finish, an edit game window will pop up. Launchbox is a game launcher, so you can customize how the game looks in your library. All this is optional, but feel free to type in the Need for Speed into the title box, which will search for the game in its database in order to fill in some metadata. You can then click the download images button at the bottom, which will then download the game's box art and whatnot. It's a nice little touch that will allow your library to look pretty-ish. When you're done, hit OK and there it is. The Need for Speed SE is installed on your computer. Right click on the box and hit play and there you go, the Need for Speed SE.
And this concludes the tutorial. If you happen to run into any issues, then I suggest you ask for help on the Need for Speed subreddit or Need for Speed Discord, as you could get a response much quicker from someone else who might have run into a similar problem compared to solely asking in the comments section of this video. If this tutorial was helpful to you and you want to see more stuff by me, then definitely consider subscribing and checking out a series I did on my channel called 25 Years of Need for Speed, where I played every Need for Speed game from 1994 to 2019, including, of course, the Need for Speed. But regardless of that though, I hope you're having a very good day. Thank you very much for watching. Take care.